Very well. There seem to be two issues here. First of all, did we hang this man out to dry? Did the American people
there's no question about that. We absolutely did hang him out to dry. And I think that one of the follow-on phases to the operation, once Osama bin Laden was identified as being the target and having been eliminated, we should have gone to the phase of extracting this doctor and his family out of Pakistan for his own safety.
What do we do now? And how did, did we blow his cover that led to his detention and ultimate penalty by the Pakistanis?
Well, I think the more that we talked about it, we violated one of the basic premises of military operations. That's OPSEC, Operation Security. And I think it kind of shows the amateur nature of this administration and President Obama in talking too much about this operation and enabling the Pakistanis to listen very carefully to some of the words and the verbiage that was using. And they were able to backtrace this and put the pieces together on their side. But then when you look at the Pakistanis, why would they charge this gentleman with treason? Because first and foremost, Osama bin Laden was there illegally. He is not a Pakistani citizen. He's a Saudi citizen. And wouldn't the Pakistanis want to see the number one most wanted terrorist in the world captured and brought to immediate justice? So for them to say that this doctor is guilty of treason means that they are aligning themselves with al-Qaeda and with Osama bin Laden, which violates everything I think that we should stand for if we're going to consider them to be our ally. As well as they continue to have the ground lines of communication, the G-locks closed, that enable the supplying of our troops in Afghanistan. You're correct. You have established a very horrible precedent, but it is also the same what we saw with the Green Movement in Iran when we left them hanging out to dry. We saw the exact same thing down in Honduras, where the president decided to support a Marxist socialist leader there who was aligning himself with Hugo Chavez. And now we see what is happening here. And that is why I cannot understand why anyone says that this is a very successful president when it comes to foreign policy. We know that the Muslim Brotherhood is running a presidential candidate in a runoff, which is something that they told the Obama administration that they would not run a presidential candidate. So I don't know if it's naivete or, as I said, it's just amateur hour in the White House. But these have serious national security ramifications. Well, I tell you that we must strongly go to the Pakistani government and demand his release. If we were so adamant about the blind dissident over in China, we should be even more adamant about this doctor and his family. Because as this doctor has been taken into custody, tried and convicted of treason, sentenced to 33 years, there's already rumors of him being tortured, and I can guarantee you that his family is living in absolute danger right now.